When I do lectures and workshops, I always get this question on a regular basis. Jason, when is the best time to upgrade my camera? And I always have a steady answer for that. You upgrade your camera when you've already maximized its full potential, when you've done everything you can do with that piece of equipment. It's also a good time to upgrade when your filming needs are not anymore met by the existing equipment that you have. And number four, this is perhaps the more important, can you afford it? Once you meet 4 out of 4 of those criteria, I think the answer is yes. It's time to upgrade. And so with that being said, please indulge me, humor me, honor me, and please join me in unboxing the new gear I have from Lumix. So let's do this! I got 2 units right away because I'm not the best colorist in the world. Having 2 units of the same model brand just allows me to work faster. I can, of course, match different footage from 2 different models or even 2 different brands, especially when I'm shooting log, but that's gonna take a longer time to bust out the edits. As you may notice, this is the kit version of the Lumix S5. This contains the 20-60mm. It's a very useful range. It's not the fastest lens. We've discussed that before. It's f3.5 to f5.6, but it gets the job done. Actually, this video is being shot right now with the S5 with the 20-60mm. I only really need one of these, but the body-only units of the Lumix S5 will still only arrive in Manila on February. But I am a very impatient man, so I got 2 of the body and lens kits right away. Nothing like new camera smell. So let's make one thing clear, guys. This is not on a whim. This decision is not on impulse. As you may well know, I've been testing the Lumix S5 for the past few months, 3 to be exact. So I've thought about it. I've put this camera through its paces. I brought it in multiple shoots, pre-weddings, weddings, which I specialize at, documentary, a fashion shoot. I even brought it to my Christmas vacation in Palawan. And it just performed stellarly. And of course, you may think that I'm a shill. You know, I'm signed up by Lumix globally and locally, and I only have good things to say about the product. Well, yeah, to a certain extent, that is true. I am a global ambassador. I am a local ambassador for the brand. But the thing is, I would never ever recommend something to you, my audience, without my careful consideration and without careful thought. I know how hard-earned your money is. I know that these are investments for our livelihoods. And so I do not take recommendations that I dish out very, very lightly because I respect you, my audience and followers. I hope that is clear. Remember, guys, this is the 4th camera in the full frame S line of Lumix. You had the S1, the S1R, the S1H, and then the S5. I actually skipped on the S1 because that is a more photo-centric camera. And then you had the S1R, which was on the same boat. The S1H came out, which was a spectacular camera. It had all the features that any videographer filmmaker would want. Codecs, image quality, image stabilization, everything that you need. To this day, the S1H is the only mirrorless camera certified by Netflix, if that means anything to you. So, I skipped the S1H because of 2 major reasons. Number one, it was just too heavy. Remember, it has a fan for active cooling because the bitrate for that camera can be driven up to 600 Mbps, which was pretty intense. So it needed cooling for the processor and the internals of the camera. Number two, and more importantly, it was just too expensive. I couldn't afford one. Now, the Lumix S5 addresses both of those concerns, plus a lot more. It delivers excellent image quality in the codecs that I need. It has excellent in-body image stabilization. I still maintain best in class. It's sharp. It produces great color. It has better AF. It's light. It's compact. It's fantastic to the touch. This is everything that I need in a camera right now, 2020. Or 2021. The way I'm talking about this camera, you would think that it's perfect. No, It's not. I have a couple of issues with it, but not deal breakers. Number one, it has a 30-minute record limit for 4K modes. For some people who do recitals, musical performances, concerts, or worship services, that may be a deal breaker. But not for me, because I'm always at my camera, knowing where to stop and start recording. Number two, there is a limited amount of lens options for the S5 and much of the S series. Remember, this uses the L mount, the alliance between Panasonic, Leica, and Sigma. But things are looking up. 6 months ago, if you ask me, things were a little bit dicey for the roadmap of L mount lenses. Yes, there were announcements. Yes, there was a roadmap, but the manufacturers were pretty slow in putting out these lenses. But within the last couple of months, and I'm getting really excited about this, manufacturers like Sigma are putting out great lenses at a great price with great construction and great glass. That's a lot of greats. I'm pretty excited with the 35mm f2 DGDN from Sigma, as well as the 65mm DGDN and the 45 2.8. Those lenses I mentioned are all native to the L mount. So that's something to be excited about. I actually have a pre-order for the 35mm from JT Photo. So along with these two bodies, I requested for the 70-200 f4. So I got a nice tele for the ceremonies that I shoot. Let's check this out. This is an F4. The 2.8 is so much more expensive, so let's save up for that in the future. So even though it's a cheaper lens than the 2.8, it also has optical image stabilization as well as a focus clutch. I had very limited experience using this lens over the past couple of months, but I knew I had to have a tele because I shoot weddings. So it just made sense that this is the first lens that I acquired after the 20-60 kit. What about primes, you say? I love primes, but the 50mm 1.4 is prohibitively expensive, either from Panasonic or even Sigma. Those are just so expensive. So, for the meantime, I still use my Sigma adapter, so I can use my old vintage FD glass or my newer Zeiss 50mm 1.4 for prime work. So, I am so stoked with this new arsenal that I have for the weddings I will shoot this 2021. Of course, I hope things pick up. I hope that weddings and events industry pick up here in the country, and that's something to look forward to and hope for. Now, the big question right now is, what do I do with my Micro Four Thirds equipment? Ah, that is a question. For the past 3.5 years, I have loved and still continue to love my MFT cameras, the GH5 and the GH5S. But as I said at the start of this video, I've done everything that I could with these cameras. I've traveled with them all over the world. Asia, Europe, the US, everywhere. Love these cameras to bits, but I have maximized its potential. It's time to move on. But I am not completely abandoning MFT. As you can see, I still ordered the 1235 Mark II, which is the best all-arounder for the Micro Four Thirds system. In social media posts, I always give this lens a lot of pain, a lot of slander. It's meh, it's blah, but this lens, it just gets the job done. Sometimes it's all you need, stuck to your MFT, and you're good to go. So in the immediate future, I'm going to run two S5s and one GH5 for the events that we shoot. So there, thank you for indulging me. Thanks for hanging out while I unbox this gear. We'll probably run a YouTube live session in the immediate future, so you can ask me about your questions regarding my transition from Micro Four Thirds to full frame, the Lumix S5, or any other questions you might have with the S5 and the L-mount system. So that's it. Happy holidays, guys. I'll see you in the next video.